and I'm Victoria. It's difficult for me to keep up with the older speakers before, so I'm a little bit nervous. Thank you all. And yes, I would like to speak about meditation and some videos ago researching in this area with scientific suicide. But nowadays things have changed, and more and more scientists paying attention to this field of studies, meditation, modern science pays much attention to it, quantum physicists and so on, as well as a general population of the world. So I want to give you a taste of this practice from several perspectives and using some quotes and studies from famous and influential people around the world. And we will follow it up with the self. So Peter told me I won't be able to keep you silent for 3 minutes. Please go for it. So Mahatma Gandhi famously said, "You must be the change you want to see in the world." Here Gandhi is telling us that personal and social transformation go hand in hand. If we could change ourselves, the tendencies in the world will also change. As a man changes his own nature, so does the attitude of the world changes towards him. There is another saying in neuroscience, and they say that neurons that fire together, wire together. So more you run a neural circuit in your brain, the stronger the circuit becomes. Like a muscle, the muscle we are training becomes stronger, and the muscle we are not training becomes weaker. So to quote, "Practice makes perfect," in our case makes, more you practice this, we become better in peace. And how can each of us practice peace on a personal, regular basis? I say meditation. Several research studies have shown that practices such as meditation can physically transform the structure of the brain and thought patterns, known as neuroplasticity. So if the brain changes, the behavior will also change. One of India's most influential people, a master mystic Sadhguru, says, "All that we have created is just a manifestation of our minds. So the most important part of creating what you want is to first manifest it within your own mindscape. What is powerfully established in your mindscape naturally bound to find your manifestation and actuality. Peace and meditation is a powerful tool for creating peace and love within oneself and then carrying out to the world." And to conclude with an empirical evidence, I want to bring an example of a Washington Prime study in 1993, led by a famous quantum physicist, John Hagelin. The project was funded with $4.2 million. So what was the study about? There were around 2,000 and 7,000 monks were meditating in that area at the same time. So they attempt to achieve a stage of deep relaxation by concentrating in a particular mantra. And they did it twice a day for 20 minutes. The idea of this quantum project was that the relaxing effect will be transmitted through a field of consciousness that unifies all creation. The assumption of the study was the resulting stress reduction in the city will directly lower the number of crimes. Does it sound even possible? This result, the study results show 4 times drop in violent crime trend due to meditating. So all causalities have been included, and there was a huge commission who were investigating on all the things which could influence it and all the other causalities. So the ancient land of India gave a message of peace and harmony to the world, to all humanity. But it did more. It gave a method, a technique for achieving it. To me, it seems that if we want peace in human society, we cannot ignore individuals, as it was mentioned already before. If there is no peace in the mind of the individual, how there can be a real peace in the world? If I have an agitated mind, always full of anger, hatred, ill will, and an How can I give peace to the world? I cannot, because I don't have it myself, no? So enlightened persons have therefore said, first, find peace within yourself. In such way, I propose meditation as an essential individual daily practice for reaching peace in the world. And on this point, I want to invite you for 3 minutes of meditation. So make yourself comfortable in your seat. Just lean back, very comfortable, fine. And relax. I know that you just had your break, but it's too nice to do it once more. Close your eyes, no worries, it will be just 3 minutes. And keep that pose. Inhale deeply, all the way down to your belly. And exhale. Your mind may be in different places, occupied with different thoughts about various people or tasks. Gather your thoughts together and bring them back to your body, to their source. Connect your body and mind by bringing your attention to yourself. Feel your legs, upper body, your arms, your head. Feel your body melt in the chair. Your mind is arriving in your body. You are bringing your thoughts back to their home. Now you are connected. You feel complete. And from here, once your mind is in your body, we go one level deeper to your true self. Your true nature, which is unconditional, unlimited love and joy. Your inner sense, which is always there, even if you don't feel it. Imagine the sun like a ball in your chest, and feel how with every inhalation, the sun is growing. You feel the warmth, you feel the light, you feel as the sun becomes bigger, and as this light flows down to your feet, and then to your arms and your hands. You feel as this light goes up through your neck. Inner smile is there with you, and you're feeling good and fine. And now you feel how the sun is coming out of you to your skin, to the surface.